Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Hey, this new book, Excel Gurus Gone Wild. Now, every time I'm in front of anyone, and I'm counting this as being in front of you, I beg people not to buy this book. Wow, it is filled with arcane stuff. It may be 1,000 years before you find one instance where you can use something cool from that book, but if you're a real Excel guru, someone who loves just every weird thing there is about Excel, wow, then that's the book for you. Most people buy one of the other books, that's the way to go. Now, yesterday we talked about how to figure out how many Monday, Wednesday, Fridays were between a start date and an end date, and I used a custom VBA function, because that's what I always do. I always just fire up VBA, but there's an amazing way to do this. Now, the items in this book came from the Mr. Excel message board. So you have the smartest Excel people around working on these problems, and they come up with amazing formulas. And when I saw this formula, I was fascinated by how it works. So we have a start date and an end date. I want to see how Excel is storing that. So I'm going to press Control and the accent key, the Grave accent. And you see that it's stored as the number of days since January 1st, 1900. So we have two numbers there, 39,632, 39,634. The formula takes advantage of something called indirect. So we take the indirect of B2 to C2. So we're saying the indirect of 39,632 colon 39,634, and then using the row function to turn those dates into numbers. Now, check this out. I'm going to use the evaluate formula. So we'll come to formulas and we'll do evaluate formula, and we'll watch how this gets changed. So we evaluate the first date and then the second date, and now indirect of that whole thing is going to refer to three specific rows. So we have two cells, but it grows into three rows, and when we take the row function, all of a sudden we have an array of those 1, 2, 3 dates. Now, here in this formula, I'm just doing something simple like summing it, but I want to show you what happens when we use this in a larger range. So here we go from May 7th to September 1st. I'm going to evaluate formula again, and we'll evaluate. All the way out. All of a sudden, when we ask for the row function, those two cells change into 100 cells easily. Look at that. Every single date from the start date to the end date. That's amazing. We're taking two cells and coercing it into this big, huge array. Now, what can we do once we have that array? Now, I'm going to go on to the next worksheet where I've actually written the formula. So I say, hey, we're going to take this big, huge array. We'll take the mod of that date divided by 7, and it's going to take each individual date in the array, add 1 to it, because the mod is going to give us numbers from 0 to 6, and then go see if it's a Monday, a Wednesday, or a Friday using the choose function, and finally sum that whole thing up. So here we'll evaluate formula here, and as we go through, you see that eventually we get down to our array. It will be 3 dates here, and the choose then turns into a series of zeros and ones, and we have one Monday, Wednesday, Friday in that range. But when we go down and evaluate formula on a larger range, let me do 9/1/2008, then miraculously, that cool trick where we take the indirect of the first date to the later date, check the row of the whole thing, turns into, again, an array of 100 dates. The choose is going to turn into an array of zeros and ones. Only the Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays get ones. Just a beautiful, beautiful formula. And then finally sum the whole thing up to get the Monday, Wednesday, Friday dates. Now, you can very easily change this formula by changing the zeros and ones over here to correspond to the days that you want. Just an amazing bit of code. And again, the thing that I love is taking the indirect of the first date to the later date, putting the row function around that whole thing, which takes just two cells and turns it into a huge array that the formula can work. Now, of course, this is an array formula, so you can't just press Enter. You have to use Control-Shift-Enter to tell Excel that we are dealing with one of these super magic array formulas. There you have it, a great solution. Very esoteric, to be honest, but if it's a problem that you have, a great trick to have in your tool bag. Again, the Excel Gurus Gone Wild book, filled with just the bizarre and arcane, but sometimes incredibly useful formulas like this one. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NetCast.